पेन ओनली चाहिए, खाली फोटो पड़ेगी.
फोटो फोटो. थैंक यू. या
गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन. How many of you are as a IFA over here? And how many feel that is a dignity business? Business of dignity. No. This is the reason why I left my job as a banker. I was a non-resident banker in the Kotak Bank. In 2014, I left my job just because of dignity. I didn't get the dignity in my banking job. When I used to visit my client, I feel that बैंकर आ गया है, अब कुछ लेके जाएगा, जान खाएगा. सो आई लेफ्ट माय जॉब इन 2014 एंड स्टार्ट माय ओन ट्रस्ट के फाइनेंशियल सर्विसेज. आई हैड स्टार्ट जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ इन बड़ोड़ा ओनली 12 फाइनेंशियल प्लानर्स हु आर वर्किंग एज अ सीएफपी एंड आई एम आउट ऑफ 12 आई एम ओनली person who is rigorously doing a CFP practicing. 12 years of total experience and managing around 25 crore plus wealth across 6 countries. My 80% client is out of India and the relatives in India who are my local clients. So if we can say it's a 100% client base are non-resident families or non-resident clients. Our mission statement is to care and enhance wealth, protect it to improve the quality for next generations. Because we most of are working and the Keyurs are also teaching us that whatever the wealth we are creating, it is for safely we have to transfer to our next generation only. But for what we are or our client are working is only to transfer some of the wealth for the next generation. So my mission is to transfer that for next generation. My vision is to provide most trusted service experience with the possible care. The most important thing in my consultancy is to care the client's wealth is the first. A value for my company is committed by heart and mind. As I got by heart and mind only with the process of serve, create a culture of relationship value by way of providing the proper advice, not by way of any relationship building like giving gift to the clients and maintaining other relations kind of. Respect for client and trust, interest first. Client interest first, always work for clients. Be a real and work for value creation. I recommend to all my clients a real what is the financial goals and what he actually get. To facilitate financial literacy to improve lives, I am conducting regularly IFPs to other this CFP practice. I am conducting every year 6 or 7 IFPs in Baroda and possibly innovative. I am starting in 2 months my own robo advisory as well with the help of one service provider. Objective of the company is basically all we have discussed, objective of the company, what all people have discussed earlier, so I'm not getting much more time for this. Having business collaboration, just for my client's best service, I have some business collaboration with chartered accountants, with some bankers as well. Banker for what? Most of the non-resident clients don't have a bank account in India. So I have a collaboration with the bank that the bank will pick up the courier, account opening form, pick up with the courier on the doorstep of the overseas doorstep, and he will collect the document, start account, and then I start my further financial planning for the clients. I have 6 legal advisor training panel for estate planning and other legal financial requirement. Real estate broker as well for the client's real estate services. 2 tax consultant for, I'm providing tax facility as well to my clients as a free of cost, whatever I charge fees, I include that because in taxation only 1500 rupees are normally charging by tax consultant. So I included that in my fees as well. And 3 travel agents for the emergency requirements of the clients. services and products I offer, as we generally know, what are the services mostly offered by the financial advisors. Business models, detailing from clients, plans, designing, product mixing, inquiry, proposals to clients, onboarding clients, monitoring and reviews. As sir has designed this process and we are implying this. Now the important things, most of the non-resident, what they are doing mistakes for their financial planning. Consider only notional gains rather than a real gain. Most of the non-residents, what they are considering, I had bought a flat of rupees 2 crore rupees and getting 3 crore after 15 years. So they realize after 15 years. More depend on local relatives and representatives. Only their there is one local relative who handle all the financial stuff as well as personal stuff. Do financial work just before few days back return to their country. अगर किसी को पूछेंगे financial planning करना है, हाँ हाँ करेंगे करेंगे. और 5 तारीख को flight है, 2 तारीख को आपको बुलाएंगे. कुछ होगा ही नहीं उसमें. Too much exposure in fixed assets rather than paper assets. उनके पास fixed assets तो नहीं होते हैं. Completely fixed asset होता है completely. Paper assets hardly they have. Most of they have insurance product or real estates. Never rely on proper advice. Mostly invest in families, friends and advice with banker influence. कभी कभी वो banker के इतना close हो जाते हैं कि banker end time पे banker कुछ sign करवाने में पता ही नहीं चलेगा क्या sign करवाया है. And most important thing कि जो भी non-residents होता है सबसे बड़ी गलती ये करता है कि जो भी investment करता है वो fixed assets में करता है और उनका next generation जो उनके child they are not interested even for their property. Whatever lying in India, not interested in. मैंने real case study लिया Mr. Patel का. उनका age है 59, status non-resident है. उनका ये current portfolio था when I met them. That's 45 lakh rupees of fixed deposit for NRO fixed deposits, which is absolutely wrong because they have to pay tax 33% flat away. 26 lakh rupees per annum insurance premium. This is the insurance premium. This is a real case study of mine. 23 lakh in post office scheme just because their neighbor is post office agent. 25,000 rupees post office recurring investment. They himself become an insurance agent. एक इंश्योरेंस एजेंट ने एडवाइजर था तो ब्रांच मैनेजर था उन्होंने इंश्योरेंस एजेंट बना दिया और फैमिली को सबको पॉलिसी देना स्टार्ट कर ली. हैविंग नो म्यूचुअल फंडिंग पोर्टफोलियो ओनली एनआरई एफडी ऑफ 1.85 करोड़ रुपीस देन आई वर्क ऑन इट. दिस इज जस्ट बिफोर 5 डेज. दिस इज द करंट सिचुएशन ऑफ द पोर्टफोलियो. म्यूचुअल फंड 1 करोड़ 55 लाख रुपीस फिक्स्ड डिपॉजिट बिकॉज़ एज अ पार्ट ऑफ asset allocation I kept in a fixed deposit in NRE fixed deposits. It said 1 crore rupees and insurance premium is hardly around 3,49,000 only. Out of 26 lakh rupees insurance premium with my advice they reduced to around 3.49 crore lakh rupees. This is asset allocation how they divided all the after all I get this because of sir's advice and my client done this 59% in mutual funds and 40% in a fixed deposits and bond kind of investments. How asset allocation and rebalancing strategy I used to acquire this client and with the help of the only this thing I acquired this client. I divided the percentage of non-resident fixed deposit, bank deposits, mutual funds, how much I put, how much in debt. I give them 9 years of total planning. Every 3 years we rebalance the entire portfolio and they convince out of this 30% only in equity portfolio and 69.5% is in debt. They are getting around 9.57 absolute returns at the end of 10 years. That's it from my side. हाँ सर वो मेरा खुद का जो मेरा खुद का ग्रोथ है एसआईपी बुक आई बिल्ड अराउंड फ्रॉम 1.2 लाख टू 11 लाख पर मंथ आफ्टर बिकमिंग ए सीएपी इन 2014 आई लेफ्ट माय जॉब एंड आई स्टार्ट माय ओन कंसल्टेंसी इन 2015 around January 2015, I missed one of my client just because of I'm not CFP. I lose a business of around $500,000 in Dubai, and I got a news that they had invested with some of CFP practicing in Mumbai. So I decided to start my CFP journey, and I met Ms. Keyur Shah sir. Then I could reach over here. My total wealth under management is 25 crore as on 31st March 2018 from 2.67 crore in
2015. Almost
like
the 8 times.
Yeah, almost 8 times. Actually, AUM growth at CAGR of 85 count is 74.67% AUM I reach after joining CFP. And one more thing I accept that I haven't do properly CFP advice, search advice. I pay two times to get the knowledge. First 6 months I haven't followed search advice, and then I pay one more time to do the complete the certifications, and after paying twice I complete my certification and I reach over here.
Good.
Thank you.
Any questions? Because he's specialist NRI banker, or you can say specialist NRI advisor. So one or two quick questions if you have.
How are you getting NRI clients?
So I'm visiting Dubai every six to eight months. I have 22 clients over there.
Okay.
Just for business, I visit. Yeah.
So वहाँ पे जाके उसका सब documentation collect करके आना पड़ता है.
हाँ. One time you done KYC ना. Then after I have own platform. I have 95% my client are on BSC mode. So most of the clients are investing by own, but they take advice of me.
What are the benefits of investing through NRE account?
So NRE account, they didn't charge any tax in India, and the important thing is it's a repatriable completely. Whatever they are going back after 10 years, 15 years, they don't have to pay any tax in India, as well as in some of the countries they don't have to pay tax over there also.
That is converted into INR only.
Yeah, definitely, sir. Definitely, I understand converted into INR. But when they want to get back that money, they have there is an option of outward remittance in bank. They can convert that particular Indian currency into another currency and get back in your in their home country. I am giving facility to my client if they want to withdraw their money. I assure that they will get their money in foreign currency. I have a bank people in my channel.
And what are the ways of bringing money from NRIs over here?
Through inward remittance of wire remittance, or by in some of the countries they send through exchange.
Whether it is preferable to do it through bank or through some?
Only through bank only. I mean, there is no option.
Third party agency,
but it's a kind of hawala, so there is no, they cannot get benefit of
non-resident. You can take a number of
Ashish
and you can keep in touch. What is the three key advantage of NRE account? One is the repatriable, second higher interest rate, and third is the tax-free interest rate. And if you are keeping money in an NRO account, means it is a taxable India, lower interest rate, and again non-repatriable. So many of time people may not aware and they remit into NRO account instead of NRE account.
So this is also part of our CFP.
Yeah, definitely. We learn everything. Okay, thank you, Ashish. Just last complete thing. Yeah. This one.